wireless communication system comprises of three blocks, transmitter, channel and receiver, and our focus is on channel. We are studying various wireless channel models to develop a simulator. Our aim is to duplicate external environment on a MATLAB environment like the one with car running around, or it can be the forest. Let us start our simulation with transmitter. A transmitter physical signal is converted into electrical signal and then to sequence of zeros and ones, that is digital signal. Let us listen to signal which we had transmitted through simulated wired channel. This soundtrack is converted into a digital signal and then passed through our simulated AWGN channel. In wired channel, noisy signal get added to transmitted signal and this added noise follows Gaussian distribution. Noise in wired channel is called AWGN, that is additive white Gaussian noise. Additive because it gets added to the signal, white because it has all frequency component, Gaussian because it follows Gaussian distribution. This received soundtrack was not clear because of the low signal power than noise power.
In case of wireless communication system also, we can improve our received signal by increasing signal power, but this time signal power required is too high. Consider a wireless scenario. Here we have considered two antennas as transmitter and other as a receiver. In wireless channel, signal can propagate to the receiver through multiple paths. One is a direct path, and in other cases, signal is reflected by cars coming in its path, or it can be buildings. And each of these paths provide different attenuation, and even signal from different path reaches to the receiver at different time instances. So, what we receive is the sum of all these signals with their respective time delays, and this summation can be constructive or destructive. If it is constructive, we have no loss. But in case of destructive interference, we lose our signal. And it is called deep fed, and this whole environment is so random that the attenuation and delay of different paths changes randomly. In case of one transmitting antenna and one receiving antenna, we have only one direct link, and if this direct link is in deep fed, we lose our signal. So if we increase the number of direct links by increasing the number of antennas at receiving end or at transmitting end or at both ends at a time, then we will get multiple direct links. And now, if one link is in deep field, we can receive our signal by other links. And by increasing the number of this antenna, we can improve the quality of our received signal.